Hey guys, welcome to our travel vlog. My name is Clara, this is Jonathan,
and
this is Ari,
and we are the Puka Travelers! And in this video, we will share with you our experience visiting the Hobbiton. Wow, and more of that day, so stay tuned with us!
Yeah! So we started our day in driving to the Hobbiton. We spent the night at the Coromandel Top 10 campsite. From the campsite to the Hobbiton is about 2 hours drive. Just on our way, we found a stunning waterfall named Roa Falls.
They are located just a few minutes drive from the top 10. The access to the waterfall is really easy. You can pull over just on the road, and after you park safely, you have a short walk to the waterfall, approximately between 5 to 7 minutes of walking. We were completely alone, there, and it was wonderful. You have plenty of time to take pictures and do whatever you want. On a good weather, you can also enter to the water, but be careful because of the strong currents and slippery rocks and deep holes that we have there. So you need a really good visibility to see where you're stepping inside the water.
After the waterfalls that were amazing, we drove about 1 hour and arrived to the main attraction of the day. The Hobbiton movie set, of course. The tickets cost $89. Yes, it's really expensive. And it includes a bus that is taking you to the cast with a short movie introduction and the guide that will show you all the place with an interesting facts about the movie and the movie set. We had a really crazy guy that was a really, really fan of the movie.
Yeah,
was it? And that's it.
The tour took us, I think, approximately 2 hours, and we really enjoyed the place. Especially, I'm a huge fan of the Hobbit movies and a lot of the Rings, so for me, it was really quite an experience. After the tour, we drove
1 hour.
1 hour and visit the Waitamo glowing Rome caves. We took the easy way of seeing the glowing Rome. It means that we took a boat, but there is more option and more fun option, like the black water rafting. So you can check it also online to see if it's open and see
if it's it's for you.
Yeah. So that's it for the second day.
We plan to arrive to Rotorua on that day, but after all the activities and the driving, we were really tired, so we spent our night really close. We spent the night at the Waitomo Top 10 site, also because we are members and it was really close. Another tip for that day: if you have no rush, you can visit a really beautiful waterfall that's located near the glow worms named the Maropopa Falls. We didn't have time. No, my little one. No, don't cry. We didn't have time at that day, and at the morning we drove straight to Rotorua. But if you have, it's really recommended. So that's it for today, and of course stay with us, stay tuned, and subscribe.
Woo, subscribe.
Bye bye.
The access to the waterfall is really easy. You can pull over just on the road, and after you park safely, you have. Damn!
Okay, hold on. Yeah.
And just on the road, and after.
Мы снимаем, тебя слышно? Stop.